Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Gareth here from tastytudes.com. In this tutorial, I'm going to discuss and demonstrate a method of how you can create a wreath logo in Adobe Illustrator. So here are some examples I have prepared earlier in various styles. Now you can find these examples in the project folder, which you can download for free. The link is in the description. Now I suggest you download the files first before watching the rest of this video. The folder contains a series of files to help you follow along with this tutorial. Okay, so at first glance, it may seem a complicated task to create wreath graphics like this. Here, we have what look like complex, intricate graphics. Now check this out. With the selection tool, if I come and select all the examples, then come into the brushes panel. If you cannot see your brushes panel, come up to Window, scroll down and access it there. For the sake of this tutorial, I'll just quickly drag it out from my panel group so you can clearly see it. Now in the brushes panel, I'll change the brush stroke to basic and click off. And all of a sudden, the wreath graphics have gone. And where the intricate graphics were, we now have simple stroke lines. So I'll press undo and we have our wreaths back. So to create these wreath compositions, we are going to use a feature in Illustrator that will make it easy to create wreath graphics like this. To do this, we are going to create custom brushes. So to create the wreath compositions, we first need to create the intricate designs and then make them into custom brushes. We will then apply the brushes to a curved stroke, much like we just saw when we set the brush strokes to basic. This will give that wreath appearance. So it really is that simple. The only tricky part is creating the wreath brushes. So here are the brushes I created that make up the wreath examples we just saw. You can also find these examples in the downloadable project folder. So these are just simple vector compositions I made using the basic tools of Illustrator. And up here in the right are some of the leaf shape vectors I used to compose them. Now if we come back to the wreath example document and look closely in the brushes panel, we can see that the vector compositions composed in the other documents have been created as brushes here, which have been applied to these examples. Now, as you can see here, under each example, we have a color and a number. So for example, here we have example number 2. If we jump back into the wreath examples, we can see up here on the left, and I'll zoom in a little, that this wreath example is using that particular vector brush. Now, with the selection tool, we can click both parts of the wreath. Here are two parts that make up the wreath, the left and the right part. If I select the right wreath part with the selection tool and come into the brushes panel and choose another brush, I can change the appearance like so. So if I select both parts and change the brush to basic, we can see two simple stroke lines that mirror each other. So these strokes were first drawn and then the custom brush was applied. Easy. I'll just change them back to the wreath brush. Now, if I quickly select all the wreath examples and change the brush to basic, we can see that these various examples were created using various stroke lines. Some overlap, some form almost perfect circles, and other strokes are shorter. Here we can also see where I have added and included other vector shapes to create the complete wreath logo. So depending on the wreath style, you first need to set up the right stroke lines. Okay, so with that introduction, let's take a look at how we can create a wreath logo composition and how I made my examples. So first we will need to create a wreath brush to work with. To create my brushes, I used the basic shape and pen tools to create vector shapes and then arrange them in various ways. Now, I'm not going to go into too much detail on how I created these brushes and how to use the vector tools, because I just want to keep this tutorial nice and short. I recommend you try and create your own brushes first. If you wish to have a go, you can use the leaf vectors here to create your own brush, or just use one of mine for now. If you're new to Illustrator and don't know how to use the shape or pen tools, you can find a beginner's guide on my channel. So once you have created a brush you want to use, next open my logo grid document, and you can find this in the downloadable project folder. This is a simple document to help set up this quickly. Here we have two squares made from guides. We have example 1 and example 2, which we are about to create. If you cannot see these guides, press Command colon to toggle the guide visibility. So with this open, I'm going to make a start, and I'll zoom in on example 1. Now first, I need to create the line strokes to apply my brush to. So I'm going to come over to the menu and select the ellipse tool. With that selected, I'm going to click and drag from the top left of the square down to the bottom right while holding shift to draw a perfect circle inside my guide. With my ellipse created, I can see the four anchor points that make up this ellipse, the top, the bottom, and the sides. So next I'll press A to activate the direct selection tool. With that active, I'm carefully going to select the far left anchor point. Once selected, I'll press backspace on the keyboard to delete that anchor point. So now the ellipse is a half circle. With the half circle selected, I'm going to come down in the menu and set the foreground color to transparent and the stroke to black. Nice. Now we have a line stroke of half a circle. So now I'm going to come and choose one of my vector compositions from my examples. So for this example, I'm going to choose this sample on the far left. So with the selection tool, I'll click and drag over all the vector shapes to select them all, and press Command C to copy. And back in my logo grid, I'll press Command V to paste in my vector comp. And I'll just move it over a little. So as you can see, this is just a bunch of vector shapes I have positioned in this way. If I want to click them and move them around, I can. Though on this occasion, I'm just going to select the bottom right leaf shape and just scale that up a little to make it bigger than the rest. I'll select the left leaf and delete this one. I'll copy and paste the big leaf and then come up to Object, Transform, Reflect, and I'll do that to vertical of 90 degrees and click OK. And then I'll just move this into position like so. So now I'm ready to create a brush from this to apply to my stroke. Now it's important to keep in mind that the brush has to be relative to the stroke you want to apply it to. Right now, this vector comp is a lot smaller than this line stroke that I'm about to apply it to. So I'm going to quickly select all of these vectors and scale them up a little bit. Once happy with it selected, I'm going to click and drag this into the brushes panel. Upon release, up will pop the new brush menu. So from here, we need to select Art Brush. I'll click OK, and up will pop the Art Brush options. So starting from the top, I'll select Stretch to Fit Stroke Length. Now in the preview window, we can currently see the arrow direction. Now I want to set this arrow from bottom to top. So I'll click this one on the direction, and then click OK. Upon click, we will now see our new brush in the Brushes panel. Now all I have to do with the selection tool is select the stroke and select on the new brush, and there is the reef brush applied. Now on this occasion, it looks like it's starting from the top and ending at the bottom. Now you can either select the shape and rotate it like so, or you can double click on the brush in the Brushes panel and modify the brush. Here I'll click the flip along square under options. On this occasion, I'll just leave this flip along option set, and I'll click OK and apply to strokes. And that will fix that issue. So with the reef part selected, I'll copy and paste and move it over. I'll come up to Object, Transform, Reflect, and flip 90 degrees vertically. I'll reposition, and there I have my full reef composition. I'll press Command colon to toggle the visibility of the guides and take a nice look at this. And that's looking great. So here is a nice example of a circle reef. But what if I want to modify the length of the reef parts? So I'll select a part of the reef I just made. I'll copy and paste and drag across like so to my example 2 grid. And I might have to press Command colon again to bring back the guides. Now if I come over to the menu, click and hold on the pen tool, I will select the Add Anchor Point tool. Now to add a new anchor point, I'll click further down the path like so. Once I have added the new anchor point, I'll press A and select the end anchor point at the top. With it selected, I'll press backspace to remove this. By removing that anchor point, we have now made the stroke shorter and the reef graphic smaller. So just like earlier, I'll copy the reef section and reflect and position it next to it like so. Simple. So just like that, I have created two very different reef compositions from the same brush by using different strokes. Pretty cool. Now, because these are currently brushes, we can toggle the stroke size. So I'll select both of the reef elements on the right, and in the stroke panel, we can see this is currently set to 1. If I change this to 2, we can increase the brush effect and make it larger. On this occasion, it's looking a little big, so I'll change this stroke size to 0.5, and here it's slimmer. Now keep in mind that tweaking the stroke size like this can distort the brush effect. Setting the stroke to 1 will be relative to the original brush pattern. So I'll just keep this set to 1. Now another important thing to bear in mind, we created the brush from a black vector composition. With the reef selected, if we now try and change the color of the stroke, let's say to red, it's not going to work. So to change the color of a reef composition, we will need to convert the composition into a vector shape rather than a brush. This will allow us to apply all the usual color and stroke effects. To do this is easy. With the reef selected, come up to Object and select Expand Appearance. Upon click, the brush will be created into a vector shape. And now you can add fill color by selecting one in the swatches panel. Now keep in mind, once you have expanded your reef like this, you will not be able to tweak the reef any longer. So be sure to keep your original reef brush composition backed up. So that's how you can create a reef logo using a custom brush in Adobe Illustrator. If we look back at my previous examples, you can see that some are overlapping. Well, if I set the brush here to basic, we can see, just like in the example we have just made, we have two strokes. Though in this instance, the strokes curve over each other at the bottom. By overlapping these strokes and applying the right brush, we can get this nice reef effect like so, where they overlap at the bottom. If I jump to the brush that I used to create this, you can see I had to add a longer vine to the reef base to accommodate for that nice overlap. So that's how you can create a reef logo in Adobe Illustrator. Once you apply your custom brushes, you can then start to add text and other vector shapes to create your own unique reef logos, like these examples I have created earlier. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video tutorial. If you liked this tutorial, hit the like button on my Facebook page. If you would like to see more videos like this in future, hit the subscribe button. Don't forget, you can download the templates you saw at the start of this tutorial. All links are in the description. Well, that's it for another video, brought to you by Gareth here at tastytunes.com. Thanks for watching, have fun guys, and I'll see you next time.